When I see, I say something happening. If it's okay or no, I was like in panic. When I go to catch the train, I talk with him.
And he started to move towards the pedestrian pavement and started to just take out the people that were in front of the car. So literally, when I realized this, the car was literally just about 1 meter away. So I had literally no time to get out of the way. So basically what I did is I just put myself in, you know, just tried to defend myself as I could. So I just put my arms forward and, you know, the car just tumbled me over and that was it basically. The adrenaline just started to take over me. I didn't want to die, so I was just like, yeah, I'm gonna be okay. Trying to convince myself that I'm gonna be okay and that my legs were gonna be okay. But I was horrified because I was scared for my life. I didn't want to die. I was just thinking, if I have something inside me that's, I don't know, probably an injury, I don't know. I was scared, but luckily, after a while, the police and paramedics, they came and they started vending me. They started, you know, wrapping me up.
I'll just be bad.
But now they will have it.
They will all have it.
Oh, really?
Well, they'll have it.
The paramedics were also fantastic, always trying to make you happy in the bad circumstances that we were passing. They was always very positive. And, you know, just, I think they did a fantastic job,
of course,
honestly.
Every second, I could not, like today I just planned to just, there is like competition. So I didn't want to give them all the story.
Right now, my emotions is pretty sad because I have to be in a bed and recovering, but I'm also grateful that I'm alive. I'm grateful that, you know, I can see my family, and, you know, it's just important always, you know, I'm thankful to, you know, to God and to just being here. It's amazing. It's like after having such an impactful event happen to me, you never think that's gonna happen to me. And it's just wonderful to be here and to, you know, like my uncle told me, you know, just take it as a new life. You're born again. Yeah.
Do you mind?
It's very bad, you know.
Yeah.
Very bad disaster, no?
For everyone,
like,
yeah.
For every. Literally, it was really, really good. Literally, like the way we got treated.
O que eu acabo de ver. Antes e depois, antes do carro bater-me em cima, antes do carro levar comigo em cima, o carro, eu virei as costas e pus as mãos para fora para tentar defender-me. O carro em si, eu estava a 1 metro do carro, já não tive tempo de esquivar-me do caminho ou nada assim, e então o carro levou-me comigo em cima. Eu dei uma volta por cima do carro. O carro estava um pouco destroçado, por isso tinha umas partes de metal para fora. Isso acho que foi os danos que fizeram em mim. E também depois, quando eu já estava no chão, só vi as pessoas a gritarem, vi as pessoas que estavam aflicionadas a gritar: ajuda, não sinto as pernas, ajuda-me, e gritavam de dores e essas coisas assim, é algo horrorífico. Dormir bem, eu sinto bem, sinto que tenho vida, estou feliz por ter vida, mas dormir é algo que já é mais difícil, é algo difícil porque vejo o carro que me voou em cima, não é? O carro que me voou em cima, estou sempre a vê-lo e é difícil dormir. Estou a tentar passar este mau momento mentalmente e ver se passa rápido. O meu tio antes de começou a falar comigo esta manhã, disse que isto é como isto é como uma nova vida que estão a dar. Deus é grande e temos que ser agradecidos por estar outro dia de vida.